Good morning everyone. Today we are starting a new chapter, chapter 20, heights and distance. So this chapter is actually the application of trigonometry. So first step, we have to read the question properly and draw the rough diagram. So we have to read the question twice or thrice till we understand the question properly, and then we draw the diagram. Okay, most of the time you will get a right angle triangle according to the question. Mark the given data and then it is easy to calculate by using trigonometric identities. So see the first question. An electric pole is 10 meters high. If its shadow is 10 root 3 meters in length, find the elevation of the sun. So here one electric pole is given, that is of 10 meter height. So we are taking AB as the electric pole and its height is given 10 meter. Now the length of its shadow, so here I am taking AC as its shadow, that is given the length is 10 root 3 meter. And the question is to find the elevation of the sun. So from this top of the pole to the ground level, join it as a hypotenuse. So here it is the right angle triangle. Here this theta, that is the elevation of the sun. So here the sun. So elevation of the sun means from here, from the horizontal level, we have to turn theta degree to observe the sun, that is the angle of elevation. So that is the elevation of the sun. So this theta we have to calculate. So in this triangle we are given the perpendicular and the base or the horizontal. So perpendicular by base is tan theta. So we are considering the relation tan theta is perpendicular by base, that is 10 by 10 root 3, that is 1 by root 3. But we know that tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So tan theta equal to 1 by root 3 and tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So when we compare tan theta equal to tan 30, that means theta equal to 30 degree. So we have to write the conclusion statement. Elevation of the sun is 30 degree. So that is the answer. Now let us see the next question. Question number 2. The angle of elevation of the top of a tower. So the angle of elevation of the top of a tower. From a point on the ground and at a distance of 150 meter from the foot, its foot is 30 degree. Find the height of the tower corrected to one place of decimal. So here the tower, I am taking it as AB. So that we have to calculate. So height of the tower we have to calculate. So I am taking it as H as the height of the tower. Now from a point at a distance 150 meter away from the foot of the tower, that is from C we are observing the top of the tower and the distance to C is 150 meter. The angle of elevation is 30 degree. So this angle is given 30 degree. Question is to find H. So again we consider tan 30. Tan 30 equal to H by 150 perpendicular by base. So tan 30 is 1 by root 3 equal to H by 150. Now H equal to cross multiplication 150 by root 3.
rationalize the denominator, root 3, so it is 150 root 3 by 3, so 50 root 3 meter. Now substitute the value of root 3 and multiply it by 50, we get the exact answer. So the conclusion statement is, height of the tower is 50 root 3 meter.
Now see the next question. A ladder is placed against a wall.
That means here we have a wall. So I take AB as the wall. A ladder is placed against the wall. So this is the ladder. BC is the ladder.
The foot of the ladder is 1.5 meter away from the foot of the wall. And the ladder is inclined at an angle 60 degree
with the ground level.
Question is to find the height of the wall.
So again I am taking height of the wall as h. So here we have to consider tan 60 equal to perpendicular by base 1.5. tan 60 is root 3 h by 1.5 meter. So h equal to 1.5 root 3 meter. Again here substitute the value of root 3, multiply, we get the exact answer. So we can write height of the wall is 1.5 root 3 meter.
So it's clear. So here students, please practice similar questions. Till question number 9 we can try to answer. We'll see it again tomorrow. Thank you.